Hey guys. So I'm here. I'm thinking of actually doing a cheat only world series. Yeah. Probably silly. Oh, the world of it. Oh. Oh yeah, that's how I supposed to do. I finally came across my first end city. But as the dragon, I couldn't really reach anything, so I had to turn back into a blaze. I wanted to get some shulker shells, so I ended up unlocking a bonus entity. I figured out what it was like to be a shulker. After getting one more entity, I turned into a bee and went searching for a gateway. I didn't have to crouch or anything, I just flew right in, turned back into a human, and jumped into the portal to go back home. As the sun set on day 100, I placed the dragon egg on another trophy island, having survived 100 days. Special thanks to Luke the Notable for inspiring the 100 days trend, to my patrons for your continued support, and to you.
Yeah, I'm going to make this.
Also, remember to follow me on all my other social media. Links in the description. Thanks again for watching.
Give up. You're too good for me. I have no idea how I'm gonna do. Let's go kaplow. Unless oh, by the way. This is really tricky to do this, so you please can you subscribe? Yeah, you can just push it, and please can you do it, because it's really, really tricky.
Imagine surviving 100 days as Hades, god of the underworld. You'll regain your demonic powers and rebuild your undead empire. Can I become ruler of the underworld? Stay tuned to find out. On day one, I spawned into the underworld as Hades, the god of death. I had spawned into a massive castle in the middle of Tartarus. And I was accompanied by my pet, Cerberus, the three-headed dog. Before having any time to leave the castle, a portal appeared, and out came a giant demon.
Hades, I've returned to take your throne, so save us the trouble and hand over control.
Iapetus, there's no way that I'm letting you take the throne from me.
That's interesting, since it looks like that's exactly what's about to happen.
Iapetus, the god of mortality, then casted a spell. I can't move, and before I knew it, I was swallowed into the red orb.
How awesome. Thank God, Cerberus. Good luck, Hades. You won't need it, since your powers will be gone in the nether.
The spell had transported me out of the underworld, and I had lost my godly powers. I was back down to 10 hearts, and was in the middle of a crimson forest biome. I cut down some wood to craft myself some wood tools, and collected some food from the nearby hoglins. It wasn't long until I ran into my first structure. I was too weak to take on the bastion, but I mined the blackstone from it to make myself stone tools. I then cooked up my food, and continued exploring until I eventually found a soul sand valley. While traversing through it, I was stopped by a giant wither skeleton. But I have no armor to deal with the Wither King. Parkouring through the landscape, I managed to make my escape and blocked myself off into a wall to hide from it. The Wither King luckily lost sight of me and returned back to the Soul Sand Valley. Once the coast was clear, I made my way back up. Before we continue exploring, let's
I love how it just says smart would die. Wait.
Two brand new battle suits, including her shirt of origin May,
Yes, right. Outside. I was just checking. Anyways. Wait a minute. Next one's the village one. Watch this. Yeah. Not like other ones. Wait a minute. I don't know how many spirals I just went through, but I knew it was more. Maybe it was all of them. Look, village. Such as Present of Comets. You can find art collections in local bookstores in the US, Germany, and France. You can enter the website below for gift codes and many more. Make sure to check out Honkai Impact 3rd's new update and download the game by clicking the link below. And redeem code MKFINAL to receive 30 crystals, 2,888 asterite, Hersher trial card, and value bundles for new players. Now let's return to exploring the Nether. Inside, to start collecting supplies to build my first house. Collected a bunch of wood, and while scoping out the area, I noticed a strange ore in the wall. I went to go mine it, and it turned out to be nether iron ore. I decided this would be a pretty good spot to build my base, so using the blocks I had collected, for the rest of day three, I built my first starter house. And finally, my
there's probably a book there.
I crafted myself a shield and an empty bucket, and went back out to search for some more nether ore. I luckily found a cave right near the
cave.
Carefully made my way down the cave. I quickly found myself another pocket of iron and plenty more by some lava. After accidentally falling into the lava, as the god of the dead, I realized I had permanent fire resistance. I then started smelting my iron and crafted myself full iron armor and iron tools. I made sure to also mine some gold and quartz for levels and use the gold combined with iron to craft myself a helm of darkness, which had the ability to turn me invisible. Once I had it equipped, I was able to go completely invisible when I crouched. With a decent amount of supplies, I made my way out of the cave and fought some piglins and skeletons on the way back to my base. For the rest of the day, I fought some skeletons and started making my way out of the biome. Also, using my lava bucket, I used it to get some cooked pork chops from the hoglins. However, I was a little bit further away from home than I realized and got lost in the Soul Sand Valley. It wasn't long until I noticed a structure in the fog. There were wither skeletons guarding it, which I managed to defeat. After getting a closer look, it was a castle. I approached the entrance and had to defeat some more wither skeletons and finally enter the strange castle. Waiting for me at the end of the hallway was the wither skeleton king. It lunged forward to attack me and the battle had begun. I used my shield to block his attacks and almost got hit by a massive strike. I then used the lava to my advantage to burn down the wither king and got hit pretty hard down to 1.5 hearts. I backed up to regen. I would need them later and started making my way back to my base. Eventually, I made it out of the Soul Sand Valley, but immediately stumbled upon a village. But before I could enter, two penguin guards rushed out to stop me.
Stop right there.
What business do you have here?
Hey, don't attack me. I haven't even done anything.
Don't play dumb with us. We know you're mateys and you're here to torture us.
Hey, that's not true.
Yeah, right. If you really want to prove your intentions, we have a task for you. We need help finding an ancient treasure hidden away in a tomb. Use this map to find it, and we'll welcome you with open arms if you succeed.
Well, that's fine by me. I'll be back shortly. After receiving the map from the villager guards, the name of the map wasn't legible, and on the map was a set of coordinates. So, using the coordinates on the map, I eventually found the entrance to the dungeon. So I entered the dungeon and started carefully making my way through. I turned a corner to find a chest, which seemed to be looted. It looked like this was a maze, and it wasn't long until I ran into demons. They weren't friendly, and they immediately started to attack me. Luckily, I was able to easily defeat them, and eventually found another chest, this time with diamonds, carrots, and gold. While making my way through the maze, I fought a few more demons, and looted a few more chests. Eventually, I seemed to have found the final room of the maze. There were tons of bookshelves and an enchantment table, as well as a chest that stood atop a podium. I decided to loot the enchantment table first and the bookshelves, and went up to the chest to see what was inside. It was a relic of immortality created by Iapetus himself. So I looted the relic, turned around, and was charged by a minotaur.
I gotta get out of here!
I made a dash for the exit while the minotaur was chasing me, and barely dodged another charge. I ended up reaching a dead end and blocked myself off and dug away.
There's one I didn't have to use any commands or blocks for.
Eventually I was cornered at the edge of a cliff. I jumped down into the lava below
Yeah, the
barely escaping the Minotaur. The Minotaur then left to return to the maze.
Huh?
I emerged from the lava to get back on land. I then started making my way back to the village to report the news. I walked up to the two guards with the relic in hand, and the two guards turned to each other. And it wasn't long after till the guards accepted me into the village. They both escorted me to their town hall, so I went to enter the building to meet with the mayor. I presented the relic to the mayor of the village, who then thanked me for helping them out. Then, with the rest of the villagers rejoiced and threw me a party. They even served me some steak, and we partied for the rest of the night. However, on the morning of day 12, one of the resident piglins noticed a strange portal outside of the village. After him noticing, I noticed it as well, and realized what it was. Iapetus, the god of mortality, had appeared once again.
Hades, I was wondering how you were doing. Do you really care about the approval of some weak nether villager? Pathetic.
Iapetus, I won't let you get away with this.
Oh, is that so? Well, I'll have my companion take back that treasure you just stole from one of my labyrinths. Let me know how the fight goes.
Is that a Belrog?
Without warning, the Belrog spat fire at me and the villager. And Iapetus fled the scene. I tried facing the Belrog, but his attacks were too powerful, and I was forced to run away. The Belrog was wreaking havoc across the village, and the villagers tried fighting back. The Belrog managed to slay a bunch of them, and I had to use my invisibility to run away. Eventually, I made it back to my base and knew I needed to get stronger to face the Belrog. So I went out to train myself against wither skeletons. I tried using my invisibility to sneak up on them, which didn't seem to work out very well. As the god of the underworld, I tried taming one of the wither skeletons, which unfortunately for me failed, forcing me to take out the wither skeleton. I also made sure to gather some more food, but when I returned to my base, there was a demon waiting for me.
Iapetus dares to send another demon?
Hades, calm down. I'm on your side. I was banished by Iapetus to the nether for disobeying his orders. Your dog, Cerberus? Iapetus is planning on killing it since it's refusing to work for him.
Not Cerberus. I can't believe this. Thank you for telling me. We must find him as fast as we can. I've gotta go right now.
After receiving the news, I remembered that the village was under attack. So I rushed back to the village to see if the Belrog had left. Once I had arrived, I didn't see any buildings. All that was left was piles of rubble where the buildings used to be, and there were no piglin villagers in sight. Instead of normal piglins, they were all zombified. I then noticed one of the zombified piglin guards. I then had a pretty good idea. I then tried using the taming ability that I had tested earlier, and it seemed like it worked. But there was only one way to find out.
I command you to jump.
The zombified piglin guard then jumped. Realizing that the piglin guard would follow my orders, I had it follow me to the building.
Oh yeah.
Can you place a block?
The piglin guard then placed a block, confirming my suspicions. I decided I was gonna tame an army of piglin guards to serve me in my own village. However, I was gonna need lots of materials in order to build my own village. So with the help of the zombified piglins, they went out and gathered a bunch of materials for me. So on days 18 to 20, I started building the new Hades village. Instead of using materials from a crimson forest, I used materials from a warped forest. This is so it fit my blue and black theme. After rebuilding each and every one of the villager homes, the village was restored. However, while the zombified piglins are re-inhabiting the homes, a massive strike of lightning happened outside the village.
Zeus, what are you doing here?
Hades, I need your help, brother. My dear pet Thunderwing has been kidnapped and brought into the nether.
What do you mean? How does that even happen?
Whatever the case is, it's here, and I want it back.
All right, I'll help you get it back. I know you're not allowed to retrieve the undead like I am. Do you know who killed him?
Well, a mortal defeated it, sending it down here.
Do you have anything you can give me to help me find him?
Here, please use this feather to locate him. I'm relying on you, brother. I'll return in a few days.
So, after receiving the feather from Zeus, he had disappeared. It was a feather from his pet, the Thundering Titan. I was gonna need to build some kind of tracker to help me locate it. So I started building myself a nether conduit. This would allow me to pinpoint the location of Zeus's pet using the feather. Once the conduit was complete, I placed the Thunderwing feather in the middle, and an end crystal had spawned in the center. It pointed in the exact direction that the Thunderwing was located. And so, with this information, I started heading in the direction of the Thunderwing. After traveling for a bit, I found myself in a basalt deltas biome. Since I was immune to lava, it wasn't too dangerous. And eventually, I found the Thunderwing. It was locked inside of an undead cage. I slowly made my way up to the cage and noticed skeletons protecting the prison. I knew I needed to be a bit sneaky, so I built underneath the
checkpoint
cage and mined